To make it easier to assign courses to employees within different branches of your organization, the iSpring Learn LMS can be set up exactly like your company. Now I will show you how to create departments in iSpring Learn. iSpring gives you a default demo structure in the Users section under Departments. Now you can delete demo content and start adding your company's personnel structure here. Then let's rename the company by selecting it and choosing Edit. Good. Next, we'll add a division to My Company by selecting New Department and filling in the required information. I'm going to add a sales division to my company. A parent department is a unit to which the sales department belongs. Then select Create. Now you can continue to add the rest of your departments in the same way. All of them have My Company as their parent department. You can also easily add subsections if you want. If you ever miscategorize a department, simply select it, choose Edit, and change it to the correct one. It's easy to find a specific department using the search tool up here. Just type in the name you want to find. If you already have a list of departments and divisions for your company, it's certainly more convenient to upload them to the training platform rather than adding them one by one. To do this, use Import. First, select Import and download the template file to import units. Open it and copy your list onto it. You must fill in the parental unit code field. If you don't know what your parent department code is, you can find it by selecting from the list and then selecting Edit Department. Here you can see that my parent department ID is 0. Of course, you can change it to whatever you like. To preserve the hierarchy, you need to ensure that the codes of the parent departments are correct. Now save the file and upload it back. And you're ready to go. After adding departments, you need to add users to them. Head over to the Users section, select the users you want to assign, and then hit the Change Department button. Now just choose the department they belong to. Okay, we figured out how to handle the organizational structure of our company in the LMS. That's all for today. See you for the next video.